Hello student, welcome back in the digital class of learning. Today we will learn about the last subtopic of the beneficial traits of transgenic plants, and today we will wind up the topic of this lesson, that is plant cell culture and application. So today's topic is biosafety of transgenic plants. What is the meaning of biosafety? This biosafety literally describes about the environmental safety as well as personal safety of the human beings. So this biosafety is based on the certain principle, certain procedure and certain ethical issues, and that should be not harming the environment as well as the person. So biosafety in transgenic plants is described as the principal procedure and policies that is adopted to ensure the environmental and personal safety. So overall, this biosafety describe about the care about environment as well as personal safety. And why this biosafety is recommended in the GMOs or this topic? The basic reason is that whatever the genetically modified organisms or genetically modified crops are there, these transgenic plants or these GMOs are having certain ethical issues, and that ethical issues are nominated as 5 ethical states of the issues that is related to the GMOs. And what are that ethical issues? Number 1 is that potential to harm human health. This is number 1 issues against the GMOs or the transgenic crops, that is the potential to harm human health. Whatever the transgenic crops or transgenic plants are consumed or taken by the human, it definitely having some adverse effect like the pros and cons, that is the benefit as well as the side effect. Second number is potential to damage environment. Actually, whatever the transgenes which is entered to the crop plant is unknown function. Some of the genes are unknown function yet. So after the entry of these genes into the crop plants, may have harming effect on the environment. Even they are responsible to habitat loss, they also help out to loss of biodiversity, etc. Now the third ethical states is impact on traditional farming. As arrival of this biotechnological aspect, traditional farming is also spoiled. The fourth one is due to the maximum production of transgenic crops or that transgenic organisms or transgenic plants, what happened there? There is a competency between the corporate sector. Some of the factories, some of the companies or agriculture farming company are producing a number of GMOs, that is the rice, wheat, corn, maize, etc. So there is a competition, and due to that existence of the competition, including corporate sector want to dominate. So there are a concept of the potent. There is a potent power that is already our own traditional rice, turmeric, neem. These are the some of the our traditional plants, but some of the foreign countries, US company, they were trying to take the potent against that. What the meaning of potent here? Potent, it is the privilege to the given to the owner or the discoverer of the particular crop plants. It means without their permission, we cannot use or we cannot alter in that type of the crop plants. So, this is a corporate dominance. Next and last ethical issue is unnatural use of technology. So, due to the excess use of the technology, what happened? We are following the unnatural needs of the technology. So, this is a little about idea about the ethical states regarding the GMOs. But this is a Environmental Protection Act. It was launched in India by the year 1986. In the year 1986, what happened? There are some measurements, there are some precautions have taken out. How do we save the environment? So, this EPA, that is Environmental Protection Act 1986. So, keeping this consideration, when GMOs were introduced in the new environment or when they are commercialized, they have to access and they have to go through the GEAC. GEAC stands for the Genetical Engineering Approval Committee. That was established in India in 1989. And what is the role of GEAC? The main role of this Genetically Engineered Approval Committee is whenever a new crops or whenever the new GMOs or transgenic plants are introduced in the environment, it is assessed, it is thoroughly checked, and more importantly that it is also checked by the five ethical sets of the crop plants, whether that plant is suitable for the environment, it is eco-friendly, or it has no side effect on the human body or other animals. So these are the certain parameters that is used by the GEAC, and after the approval from the GEAC, that crop plants are introduced and commercialized. So there are some of the basic concerns related to the biosafety of transgenic plants, and it is as: number one is safety of GMOs food for human and animal consumption. Just I told, when these GMOs, genetically modified organism or the crop plants, are consumed by the human body, what happened? The genes which is called transgenes, which is introduced in the vegetables or the crops, it reaches to the human body or the animals or other animals, it causes organ failure, allergies, toxicity, and sometimes it is also responsible for the immune suppression disorder, diseases, as well as cancer. You might be heard about that somebody is not taking the tobacco, they have not taken any sorts of these drugs, but they suffer from the cancer. So because of the transgenes. Next, effect on the biodiversity and environment. Just I told that EPA is the main motive is to save the or to conserve the environment, and it must be very eco-friendly. So after the entry of these GMOs, whether these GMOs or these genetically modified plants having adverse effect on biodiversity as well environment. So there is an example of that GMC, that is genetically modified crop, that is the corn plant. It has the herbicide tolerant power. But these herbicide tolerant power, crop plant is fatal or it is very harmful for the monarch butterfly. It has displaced or it has destroyed the habitat of the monarch butterfly. So this is the loss of biodiversity. Next, gene pollution and super weed aspect. GMC is also related with the gene pollution. What is the meaning of gene pollution here? What happened when the pollen grains are reaching to the plants, that is the GM transgenes. So transgenes are that already present in the pollen grains, and these transgenes which is present in the pollen grains reaches to the next crop plants by the means of the transport of air, water or insects or natural way. So these causes the pollution in the plants. So gene pollution can be described as the transgenes which reaching to the pollen grains, it pollinate the other plants and causes some side effects. Now the super weed aspect, what the meaning of super weed and super bug? There is a two words, super weed and super bugs. The super weeds and super bugs are the highly tolerant, herbicide tolerant resistant plant, or these are the herbicides resistant plants. So these weeds have no effect while we are using some herbicides or weedicides on them. So this is called the super weeds. So GMC support the some of the plants which have the power to have herbicide resistant, or they can tolerate the herbicides or the weedicide power. So they create the super weed. Super weeds are those plants which are not affected by the any sorts of the herbicides or the weedicides. Next, these transgenes, which is where their main aim is what? To produce the fruitful results. But what happened? The fruitful results could not achieve. In spite of that, what happened? The natural quality of the vegetables, crops or the fruits may be changed. So that is called the fundamental changing of the natural vegetables due to the transgene. So after the entry of the transgenes in the crop plants, the fundamental behavior or the natural quality of the plants will be changed. Next, antibiotic resistance. Mostly we are using the antibiotic resistance as a marker gene. Whenever this antibiotic resistance gene are transferred to the desired crop plants and that crop plants are consumed by the human body or other animal cells, what happened? These antibiotic resistant after reaching the human body or in the gut, that is the intestine, their concentration will be little increased and it work as a antibiotic resistant. Sometimes when the person is taking some medicines for their treatment or for the cure, so that antibiotic will be not much effective as it should work. So this is the antibiotic resistance. So this is about the some of the biosafety transgenic plants. So in the year 2000, that is 1996, year 1996 to year 2014, there is a list of the GMOs or genetically modified crop plants are given in the tabulated form that different countries worldwide, and it depicts about that, or it clear, or it is revealed about that. So there is a increased concentration of production of the transgenic crops, but these transgenic crops are equally useful as well as they are also harmful, like the prunes and the coons system. So these transgenic plants are having some of the biosafety and they are sometimes very harmful if they are not properly treated. Thanks for watching.